Hello friends, welcome to SK Learning Temple. Today we learn about priority scheduling and round robin scheduling. Now what is priority scheduling? Priority is assigned for each process. So for each process a priority is assigned. Process with highest priority is executed first and so on. So process with highest priority first will be executed and so on. Process with same priority is executed in FCFS manner. Priority can be decided based on memory requirements, time requirements, or any other resource requirement. So let us take an example for this. So there are, let us suppose there are four processes, P1, P2, P3, P4, there is bus time is given and there is priority is given, their priority is given. So what will be the net chart here? So net chart here, so in the priority scheduling what happens? The priority with the process with highest priority is executed first. So process with highest priority is executed first. So here highest priority process is P2 process priority 1. Priority 1 is the highest process than priority 2. So P2 will execute it first. So for 0 to 3, bus time is 3. So 0 to 3 will be P2. Then the process with priority 2 will be executed. For 3 to 24 priority 2 process will be executed, and P4 priority 3 process will be executed 26, and at last P3 priority 4 will be executed 32. If two processes have the same priority, if suppose P1 P2 has same 2 priority, then process with same priority is executed in FCFS manner, they will be executed than in FCFS manner, but here different priority for different process. So this will be the net chart. Now let us calculate the throughput. What will be the throughput? Throughput means number of jobs per unit time. So here the number of jobs are 4 and time is 32. So for 4 by 32 job per millisecond, if unit time is millisecond, 4 by 32 job per millisecond equal to 0.125 job per millisecond, it is throughput. Now turnaround time, so what will be the turnaround time here? For P1, turnaround time is process completion time. So process completion time for P1 is 24, for P2 is 3, for P3 is 32, and P4 is 26. So for P1 24, P2 3, this will be the turnaround time. P1 24, P2 3, P3 32, P4 26. So average turnaround time will be 24 plus 3 plus 32 plus 26 by 4 equal to 85.4 is equal to 21.25 millisecond. It will be the average turnaround time. Now waiting time. Waiting time for P1. So P1 waits for 3 millisecond to start the execution. Waiting time P1 to 3. Waiting time for P2 is equal to 0. For P3, 26 millisecond. After 20 millisecond, it started execution. So waiting time for P3 is 26, and for P4 equal to 24. So this will be the waiting time 3, 0, 26, and 24. Average waiting time 3 plus 0 plus 26 plus 24 by 4, 53 by 4 equal to 13.25 millisecond. So it is a it was the priority scheduling. Now we move to the round robin scheduling. So what happens in round robin scheduling? In round robin scheduling, a fixed time is allotted to each process called quantum for execution. So for execution, a quantum is allotted to each process. Once a process is executed for given time period, for given quantum or given time period, that process is preempted. That process is preempted and other process executed for given time period. So that process stopped its execution. Preempted means stopped its execution. So that process is preempted and other process execute for given time period. Context switching is used to save states of preempted process. So if one process is preempted, then again can it execute it later. So context switching is used so that if one process is executed, then any other process can be executed. So here the example, process and bus time has been given, P1 20, 1, P2, 23, P3, 6 and P4, 2. This is the first time. Now let us assume that quantum is equal to 5. So here what will be the net chart? So in round robin scheduling, every process executed for quantum time. So at a here quantum is 5. So net chart will be like this. For P1 will be executed, first P1 will be executed for this quantum period. Now P2 will be executed for this quantum period, but P2's execution time is less than the quantum, so P2 will execute it for 3 millisecond time. Now P3 will execute it for quantum time. P4 execution time is less than quantum time, so P4 executed for 2 millisecond time. Now again P1 will be executed for quantum time. Now P2 already completed execution. Now P3 will execute it. P3 already executed 5 millisecond time. It has only 1 millisecond, so P3 will be executed for 1 millisecond. Now P1 again will be executed for quantum time. Now P1 already executed 5 millisecond, here 5 millisecond, 10 millisecond, now 15 millisecond. Now it will be executed again quantum time, so 15 plus 5 equal to 20 millisecond, and at last 1 millisecond remaining to execute it. So at last 31 to 32, 1 millisecond will be executed. So what will be the throughput here? Now throughput is total number of job is 4 and total time equal 32. So 4 by 32 equal to 1 by 8 equal to 0.1 by 125 job per millisecond. Now turnaround time for different process. P1 completed in 32 so millisecond. So turnaround time for P1 is equal to 32. For P2, P2 turnaround time will be 8, P3 13 and P4 will be 15. So P1 is 32, P2 is 8 millisecond, P3 is 13, P4 15. So it will be the turnaround time. So average turnaround time is 32 plus 8 plus 21 plus 15 by 4 equal to 76 by 4 equal to 19 millisecond. Now let us calculate waiting time. So here is the tricky part. What is the waiting time for P1? Now for P1, waiting time is first when P1 executed, then waiting time was 0. Then P1 stopped its execution, P1 was preempted, and P1 stopped its execution after 15 minus 5 means 10 millisecond time. P1 again started execution, so waiting time is 0 plus 10. Now again it waits for 1 millisecond. So 0 plus 15 minus 5 plus 21 minus 10, 20. So 0 plus 15 minus 5 plus 21 minus 20 equal to 10 plus 1, 11 millisecond waiting time for P1. Now what will be the waiting time for P2? For P2 waiting time will be 5 millisecond. So P2 is here only, there is no P2. So waiting time for, and P2 completed here. So waiting time is only 5 millisecond. Now what will be the waiting time for P3? For P3, P3 here wait 8 millisecond. Now 8 to 30 millisecond is executed. Now again stopped its execution, and from 20 millisecond it started its execution. What started its remaining? It completes remaining 1 millisecond. So waiting time for P3 is here 8 millisecond, and here is 20 minus 13. So 8 plus 20 minus 13, 8 plus 7 equal to 15. For P3 waiting time is there. That now for P4, P4 started is 13 and P4 completed resolution here, started is 13 and ends in 15. So P4 waits 13 millisecond only. So waiting time for P4 is 13. Now average time will be 11 plus 5 plus 15 plus 13 by 4 equal to 44 by 4 equal to 11 millisecond. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please press like button. If you want to get more update, don't forget to subscribe.